guys. Today we will discuss CU-CET exam. What's mean by the CU-CET exam? What is the eligibility for that one? If you will pass that Central University entrance test, then what will happen? In how much courses you can get the admission? So today we will discuss each and everything about the CU-CET exam. And one important thinking, in this year 2019 you can get admission. So when is the application form is starting, when its result will be available? So today we will discuss each and everything. So now start CU-CET exam. So let's start. If the CU-CET means it is a Central University's Common Entrance Test, which is organized for the providing admission into the various UG, PG and other courses offered by the Central University across in upper India. Means if you want to be UG or PG admission in some universities which is involved in that CU-CET exam, nearly 10 universities given such type of the exam, combine together and give one exam only. So if you want to be campus in campus admission, so such type of the exam you should be pass. So how much courses in that one, if you will pass that exam, so how much courses you will get? See here, name of that course is UG and integrated courses. If you want to be admission in that one, so 47 exam in that one. If you will pass that UG CU-CET exam, so you will get the 47 across the 47 universities in that one that you can get the admission. And B.Ed, P.G, M.Ed, integrated M.Sc, B.Ed and P.G diploma program, nearly 226 exam in that one, programs in that one. So MPhil also, PhD program, 136 program or universities in that involved. So you can get that such type of the admission. And in 2019, what will be the date? IMP events and details of 2019. First of all, events. Online application form will be available 19 February 2019, and issue date of the admit card from April 13, 2019, and this exam will be conducted April 28 to 29 in 2019. And answer key, if you will be give the exam, answer key will be uploaded April to 13. Then how much universities are involved in that one? Central University of Haryana, Central University of Jammu, Central University of Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kashmir, Kerala, Punjab, Rajasthan, South Bihar and Tamil Nadu. These all are universities which are getting the CU-CET exam combined together, and only one exam will be conducted by these all 10 universities. If you would like to be fill that form, so you should require the code. This all are a code of that university. CUHAR means Central University of Haryana, Central University of Jammu, Central University of Jharkhand. These all are having the code of that one. These all are a code. So if you want to be form fill, so you will require this code. It is important. Then how much subject you required? Subject for the CU-CET exam courses. For UG exam, you should pass over eligibility. Means if you want to be admission in a UG in these 10 universities, so you should be pass 12th, 50% 12th exam, 45% 12th exam for the SC. And if you are open category, So you need 50% in 12th. Means in which subject you should be get the 50%? So physics, chemistry, mathematics and biology. ETC, whatever you was the exam phases, so you need 50% if you are in a general category. And if you are in a SC or ST category, so you should need only 45%, means 5% relaxation in that one for SC and ST. For you, this all was for the UG courses. And for the PG courses, 55% in UG, means in bachelor degree, you need the 55% for the general category. And 50% in UG for the SC and ST category if you required such type of the exam. So you should pass minimum 50% in UG for SC and 55% in UG for general category. So if you would like to become a master in that degree, so bachelor's in the same field or any associated field of the course in which you wish to take master, so you should pass 50% in UG for SC and ST. So you should pass 55% in UG for the general category. Okay, so let's see the eligibility. Means if you will pass that exam, so which type of the courses you can get. So candidate must qualify 10 plus 2, means 12th or its equivalent examination from a recognized board or university. If you will pass 12th class or its equivalent exam from a recognized board or university, so you will get qualify for the CUCT exam. For the research program, should complete your PG with NET, SET or GATE. Means if you want to be requirement, if you want to be a research fellowship or ETC research program in universe, in that universities, you should be passed NET, SET and GATE. Third number, for admission to some integrated courses like the MBA, LLB or any other general courses in that one also. So if you want to be in that one admission, only one paper comparison of 100 MCQ will be held. Only one paper for that one also. The admission for this some integrated courses like the MBA, LLB, much and more exam in the much and more papers in that one. So you can get the admission LLB, MBA, BBA, like this, such type of the exams in that one. There is a provision of negative marketing, 0.25 marks. If you will get 100 marks, and if your 1 marks will be the deducted, if your one question is wrong, so you will get 0.25 marks will be deducted. Means 1 equal, if your one answer is correct, so you will get 1 marks. If your one answer is wrong, so you will minus 0.25 marks, means 1 and 0.25 for the negative will be deducted for each incorrect response. Last one, on the basis of this merit list, candidate will be called for the counseling and for the choice filling process. Means if you will get once more, I repeat that one, CUCET exam, if you will first time will be faced, then after that you will go in the filling process of the exam. Means it is the common test. After that you will get the admission in that one. About the paper, examination mode will be, the exam will be conducted through the offline mode. Means only the paper will be given and you should fill that paper. Which type of the paper will be? So type of the question. The question will be the based on the multiple choice question. MCQ will be remain in that one and you should tick mark of that one, MCQs. And language, the language will be asked only in the English. English language is compulsory for that one. Duration of the exam, each paper will be only 2 hours duration. Only 2 hours duration will be the each paper. And marking scheme, each correct answer will be awarded with the 1 marks. And negative marking, for each wrong answer, 0.25 marks will be deducted, which I was explained before that one. So it was about the paper. After that, section and number of the questions. What type of the section in that one and how much question remaining in that one. So part 1 having the 25 question in that one and part B having the 75 questions. Part A means general aptitude, part B means integrated related course. Some integrated papers after that having the only 100 question, only one papers, not to be part or not to be part B. Such type of the exam will be held in the 2019. So again I would like to repeat the highlight of the important details. So let's see, online examination online application form will be available 19 February, means you can fill that form from 19 February 2019. If you are interested, so fill that one. Link will be given in the description below. Issue date of the admit card will be given also in description below, April 13, 2019, and exam date will be the April 28 to 29, 2019, and answer key will be uploaded of the April 13, 2019. Okay, so thanks for watching.